What's up, metalheads, freaks, and geeks? Some of you might be saying, Jeff, that's a 8x8 fucking wall that weighs like 400 pounds. How's a one-legged dude gonna move it all by himself? Watch. If I used a brain pan the way I think I should have used it, it might work. Otherwise, I could just like drop everything and just go, fuck it, start over. But we'll see, man. Keep an eye out. There may be some windage in the video, so account for that. But yeah, I'm about ready to move that 8x8 wall, stand it up, and then I'm gonna drag it with my ATV. What I did, if I don't know if you could see on each end here, on the ends, I put basically kickstands on them. I screwed them on there. Hopefully they hold, and I can set it down easy and flip it up on its end. And then I got to slide it into its position over here. I don't know if you can see right there, in that little bald spot in the driveway. That's where my ATV goes right there. Then I got to build a 2-foot pony wall at the end of the deck there, up, and then I gotta level this out so that it's level with the deck when I go up 8 feet. So I gotta measure down to the ground 8 feet and then come up to 8 feet, and then I gotta adjust accordingly. But then I gotta build the pony wall to match the height of this. Let's see if I can do this. Yep, recording.
wood's getting hung up. I actually planned it to do it this way. This way when I build it, I can just tip it right off by pulling the stuff out from underneath it. I don't want it slamming down, because I don't want these to break off. I built it like that on purpose so that when I did get the wall, I could just pull that bottom part out, or the other part of the platform out, and then I could just let leverage pull it forward. I don't want it crashing down because I don't want to bust off them legs I just screwed on there to keep it straight up and down. Be able to walk it up. how you do that. Now I gotta get it over there. I don't think I can move it myself. I screwed these up a little higher, like a half inch higher, so that I could drag it off the bottom plate. Get the winch out.
In all actuality, this is the first time I actually had to use my winch. Right on. See if we can get a better angle here. Thank you.
Well, if I would have thought that out just a little more, or if I had a body here, somebody that could guide it while I pulled it in and lift it up, it would have went a lot smoother. But being I'm a one-legged man and have to do things my way, that's how you get it done, man. Whew. Let's check it out. Wow, 40 some minutes to get that done. Holy shit. Well, as you can see how it's going to be. Now, what I got to do is set this wall, get it level up and down, this way and that way, get some dirt underneath the board there so it sits nice and level. And as you can see, it's higher from here to here, from there to there, it's higher. So what I got to do is I got to build a little wall right here, going along my rail here, up this high to meet that so I can put the roof on. And I got to do that before that sun sets. So I got about 3 hours to figure it out and get it built. And yeah, what the fuck, man? That took a minute, man. But hopefully, guys, next time you get a video about this project here. As you can see, I do things a little bit differently. They take a little bit longer, but they get done slowly but surely. And as you see, without wrecking a whole bunch of shit. Right on. But yeah, that's gonna fit my Kawasaki over there, right underneath there, because that's gonna be my main grocery getter. And I got tired of digging 8 feet of snow off of it the last winter. So yeah, this right here is gonna be a half wall like it is right now. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna once I get it done is I'm gonna screw that tarp down like it is now, but I'm gonna get an 8x20 tarp and I'm gonna wrap it all the way around to the bottom there, screw it up, tuck it up underneath, and then screw it from the back side, wrap it up over, take it up over the roof. That's going to be 16 feet. And then down this wall right here, I'm going to screw it in so that it's nice and tight and sealed. And then, yeah, and then I'll just put a couple drop. I'll screw some tarps to these sides right here so that I can bungee them down and keep them from flapping around. But my wheeler is 10 foot long. This is only 8 foot long, so the ass end of my wheeler is going to stick out a little bit. So I'm going to have a tarp that hangs off the top of the roof that goes over here. And then I'll just bungee it up to the four-wheeler so that all the snow can stay out of the back end of the ride. Right on. But hope you dug that. Like before, if you watched the whole damn video. But I'm a fucking trooper. At the end of your comment, man. Right on. That way I know who watches the whole damn video. Right on. Woo. But I got some work to do. Got to level this out. Get that wall built. And then connect the top. Tomorrow I'm supposed to get some snow. So we'll see. Love, peace, hippie grease.